buddy. What's up, everybody? OGT Live, once again, episode 73. We are smoking a very special cigar. With me is my wife, Mallory. We just lit up the Cigar Festivus. I'm going to go ahead and pull this. This is Cigar Clown's Festivus. And, There we go. This is a 6x55 box press Habano Maduro. And this particular blend, Festivus, was dropped last year. And due to the high, like, popularity and due to everyone's enjoyment, it has come back, but in the form of a tweaked blend, a little bit different. We're going to jump in there because not only do we have the cigar us on, the society on, but also the Cigar Clowns who are going to be joining us. If you're watching this, go ahead and drop down your comments what you are smoking tonight. We've got Zach Andrews saying smoking is Sumatra Test Blend. Oh, thanks, Eric. That is a incredible cigar. I absolutely love that cigar. But this is the first time I've lit up this year's Festivus. So really awesome start. What are your thoughts so far?
I'm still getting started. You gotta start me off and put me on the
spot. Something I remember about last year's drop, and it's definitely prevalent in this as well, is that all of like the, if there's any pepper or spice, it's very complimentary, and it's not the forward flavor that you're gonna experience within this blend.
I didn't get that off of, yeah.
Exactly. It's subtle and it's there, and it's definitely there on the retro, but it's more chocolate forward, which is something I really, really enjoy.
I think I was getting distracted by, like, I really like this kind of box press where it's, like, really sharp.
Stark bark. Yeah.
Regular. And I'm just, like, I was kind of distracted by that. So I'm, like, I'm not on top of my
great, great size. So this is one of the drops I'm most excited about for this year. I'm going to pull up a few comments and we'll get into it. So we got James saying Festivus has been lit. Awesome. We got Jason. Hi, guys. Hey, Mallory and Eric.
Hi, Jason.
And Chris Hamilton, good evening, everyone. Smoking a Festivus, happy holidays. So awesome. Glad you guys are able to join us for a very, very special night. But this, well, I mean, I'm excited about all the drops that come through the year for OGT Cigar Society. What would you say, like, out of the last, let's take, I don't know, this last 2022, a memorable cigar that we smoked from the society that you enjoyed, maybe a bit more elevated than the others?
That's hard to pick. I don't have your kind of memory. I'm trying to remember which specifically.
I remember you enjoyed the Agonorsa signature.
Yes. Yeah.
You enjoyed the, it was either the Tyler Durden See No Evil.
I really liked See No Evil.
See No Evil.
I like Tyler Durden too. It's just we smoked a whole lot of it filming that video. So
that's true. We had a lot.
It was delicious. It was amazing.
Well, and I've always said this before with some of the drops that come through the society, when it's Cigar Clowns, it's always like this, like, take a breath because we know it's going to be great. 5150 did not disappoint. It was very different in the fact that it was a 6x60, very big ring gauge as we smoked last month, but excellent flavor on it the whole time. So let's see here. We got Lord Marco. Good evening. Thank you for jumping on. And Stallone Maduro for Zach Andrews. Yes, also an incredible one. But this particular drop is very special to me. So I'm going to give you a little bit of background before we have the clowns jump on. So we were able to get our hands on a test blend that Cigar Clowns were going to come out in 2023. And that is the Sumatra, the Man Who Laughs Sumatra that everyone got within their five pack. Normally we're sending the five pack to everyone, same cigar, but this year we wanted to do something special. So when I had Joe from the Clowns on, I was saying, I was like, it's too bad. I don't have like enough previous releases to add that extra mystery cigar. But then he was able to send that Sumatra, absolutely fell in love with it. It was like within 24 hours, I was so happy. And then I was so sad because I found out with at the end of that, that it will not be able to meet production. However, we did have enough that we were sent just in time to make certain every society member gets one of those Sumatras. So it's very, very special, but I would highly encourage you, even though it's a one and done, smoke it, experience it because it's got a year of age and it's incredible. So don't miss out. Let's see here. We got Eduardo jumping on. Good evening. Thanks for joining us. But I've probably pontificated enough. We should probably have the clowns jump on. People are probably getting tired of this voice. So help me welcome the clowns. Hey, Joe and Ray, how you guys doing?
Hi.
What's up, how guys?
How's everything?
Good.
Eric, you're very good at pontificating. Don't worry about it.
So it off to an incredible start.
Having to say too much. I like to smoke. I just,
there we go.
Don't have as much to say.
She has better things to say than I. Certain. So Joe was saying off the air before he jumped on that this pairs really well with a hot chocolate. What's your experience been? There we go. And
this blend, this blend is definitely holiday feeling vibes, and this is the reason why we wanted to do the Festivus again, because this particular blend, even though it was tweaked a little bit from last year's prior blend, it has that holiday feel to it as you go through the cigar. It's got that hot cocoa. It's got that, you know, I don't want to ruin it because you're smoking it for the first time. But for me, my standout on this stick is the final third. The final third for me is the very special part of this stick.
Let's not jump ahead, right?
I just said it. It's saying right away. I'm
it's a preview. Forward.
It's a journey.
Well, and you definitely have that. As far as like
that chocolate bowl,
cocoa,
right off
chocolate element to me, it's more of that like Mexican hot chocolate to me. Because that spice, that there's that like cinnamon spice on the back end that again is very complimentary. It's not in your face. It's just another layer on the cigar.
Agreed.
We got a few comments I want to pull up here. Rob Brown, who is a member here, said, I screwed up. I'm at work. I forgot and smoked my Festivus yesterday, so I'm smoking a Not Ron with you guys now. Still an amazing cigar.
Fantastic. Appreciate that.
We got Chris Hamilton saying, clowns, I love your stuff. Can't get enough. That is always the issue. Never get enough. That's always the issue. That's been the journey of OGT with you guys. Well, I think this will be enough. Oh, I should have gotten more.
True story.
So,
we're blessed.
We're coming to the end of 2023. I'm sorry, 2022, moving into 2023. How has this year been for you guys as far as releases and all of that?
Amazing.
It's been a roller coaster, man.
Yeah.
It's been a a lot of growing pains. And it's just been amazing. We have a great team, and we're just muscling.
Yeah. What? And I know you guys.
I maybe Joe cut out.
Yeah, sorry about that, Joe. We lost your audio for a second.
Reconnecting. Probably got a message. Probably not the most.
What about
technical difficulties?
What about for you, Ray? How's it been?
It's been I said it in the beginning of the year coming out of Festivus last year into January, so this is gonna be the year of the clown. And I think we kind of held weight on that this year with the Three Ring Circus and the limited run with the Scaramouche, which is kind of reminiscent. The Sumatra is actually kind of reminiscent of the Scaramouche and how limited it was, but it's something that we didn't wanna, potentially, miss out on, and we were happy we were able to get it out to you guys in the society as kind of like a thank you to you and your members for being such big supporters of ours and, believing in what we do and, having the Redux of the Ron with the Not Ron come out in the LCA in September. Couple of exclusives that went out this year, the Heartbreaker, the 5150, which was kind of out of our ballpark as far as sizes are concerned and doing something completely different that we haven't done before. And now finishing out the year with the Festivus, it's like Joe said, it's been a roller coaster, a lot of growing pains, a lot of ups and downs. But you know what? We say goodbye to 2022, within a couple of weeks, and then it's on to the next year.
It is always moving forward on the journey. And Mallory, because Mallory's palate's very different than mine, and that we like meet in the middle sometimes. But then she also enjoys other things that not necessarily my palate. So out of the clowns drops we've seen through the society, we've had Clowncero, 5150, Heartbreaker, this one. We didn't drop it through the society, but we had the Not Run. What would you say is one that was one of your
I
more
love
favorites?
The Heartbreaker.
The Heartbreaker?
I love the Clowncero just because I'm a Lendo.
Clowncero is hard to beat. Clowncero is hard to
beat.
That one still, it's so funny because you were asking and I keep thinking about last year's drops and I'm like, oh, the Clowncero. I'm like, wait. That was this year?
February.
That was this year. That was February.
Time goes. Time
okay.
flies.
So I was gonna say that.
Yeah. So
people are still talking about the Heartbreaker video.
we will get another video out there for certain.
Awesome.
Things just got so.
Yeah, no, dude. Here. Listen, we appreciate it, man. It's awesome.
So we got Raider Dave on saying, "What's up, Eric?"
Raider Dave.
I just lit this awesome cigar, and I felt it would be fitting to pair it with some Jack Daniel's Sinatra Select. Awesome. There you go. There you go. Okay. Peter Dave, why aren't you here? Like, we could share that pairing.
Like, seriously.
We also, let's see here. We got a very serious question for you.
Ooh.
is going to determine a lot in your journey in cigar smoking. We've got a question from Ezekiel saying, ask the clowns, Giants or Jets?
I bleed blue all day, every day.
What is that?
Blue all day, every
day. That's
right. How about Sue? Yeah. Big blue, babe. That's my team. G-Men.
There you go. We got another Giants, pairing here.
Giants, Yankees, Knicks, Rangers. Those are my four teams.
Well, all right. Your cigar just got better.
Yeah. Let's go.
Jason's saying, loving Festivus, pairing with Jim Beam, Devil's Cut. Awesome.
Devil's Cut. Okay.
So, okay. From what I remember, I could be wrong. It is, I mean, it's been a whole year. I've got like, I think, two original Festivus in my personal humidor, but I feel like this has a bit more body than last year's blend. And it could be me, but from what I remember, like I said, it's been a year, but it's got a lot of body for it.
Yeah, it's definitely a little bit more dense than the last one.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. But you're talking about what?
The chocolate thing. I do get some coffee. I feel like I'm getting some coffee. Okay. On like the like retro or I don't know, because there's a little bit of that like more complex note.
Yes.
On it.
True to clown form, for certain.
Yeah, I would say more of like an espresso bean, more than a drip coffee. Yeah.
There we go. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it is espresso where it has that.
Joe's back. Can you hear me all right?
I hear you, brother. Sorry, man.
There we go.
All right, so we're going to have some of the society members kind of jump in and out.
Thanks again.
See you, Mallory.
So with all the coming to the end of the year and such, what would you say when you guys put out a cigar and you've put out we've all been happy about this, how awesome it's been to have a lot of clown drops, but it's been more than like the previous years. What is the hardest part of the journey per release? Like when you're releasing a cigar, is it the beginning of finding that stick? Is it right before the release happens? Like what is the challenge, the most challenging moment for you guys?
I'll let Joe answer since he got booted off and I've been doing all the talking.
I think it's the night before the release, and you know, just thinking of if everybody's gonna like our cigar, man. You know, as an ultra craft boutique, you know, company, you know, we're only as good as our last cigar.
Right.
So we go through the process to ensure it's a banger. But that being said, we don't know how it's going to be. And this year we had a lot of different issues, right? We had hurricane issues, we had production issues, we had shipping issues.
Yeah,
we had so many issues this year. It's like, what else could happen? And you know, and it's the end of the year, and hopefully everything is getting flushed out, and you know, we're starting off 2023 fresh.
Yeah,
with a pep in our step. You know. And you know, that's it, man. We're just gonna keep the journey.
Yeah,
and I hear a lot of people using that term. That's
true.
The journey to find the perfect.
You better get some royalties on that.
Yeah.
Sugar royalties on that.
Everybody, we're gonna start charging people royalty fees. That's right, because it's patent.
So we got
signature mark pending.
We got a question from Nick here. How do I join? So actually, really good question. Right now, if you head over to Oak Glen Tobacconist, we literally have 7 spots left. Now, here's the thing. 7 spots left for the society. You get the 4 Festivus. You get the 1 Sumatra. But on top of that, we're locked in for another month. In other words, we can't take on any new members the following month. So I highly encourage you to jump in on it, because this is, like I said, one of the most exciting drops we've had. I've been really looking forward to this, as well as we've got a really incredible broadleaf cigar coming from Mr. Stulak next month. So keep on this. Head on over to OGT and get your membership, because once it's closed for an entire month.
That was our partner, Nick. Nick, I sent you the link. I sent it twice. Just click it, and it should bring you right in. If it doesn't work, I'm sorry.
There's such a technological sound.
So, what do you think about dropping some news about next year? About some potential trips?
Yeah, man.
I'm game.
You could drop some breaking news as long as everybody. I know you got a lot of people there.
Yeah. So anyone watching right now, I had the honor of meeting all the clowns, most of the clowns.
Oh, we had the honor.
Three of the clowns. Over in Orlando when I flew over there, and you have the opportunity to meet them as well because the clowns are coming over to OGT on the 20th of April. And we are going to have some exclusive clown cigars there, as well as some bangers that have dropped in history, such as the cigars we've been talking about, Clown Cero, Heartbreaker, AVV, Original Festivus, all these cigars, you will have an opportunity to pick them up if you come to the OGT event. So meet the clowns April 20th weekend. It's going to be that Saturday or Sunday, so mark your calendar. Don't miss it.
Yeah, we'll come.
Definitely that Saturday. Definitely that Saturday.
Yes.
We are gonna have a fucking blast. We're gonna have a blast.
It's gonna be awesome. So, right now, I'm gonna ask if Curtis would like to jump on. We're gonna have one of our society members. We're getting into the nitty gritty of this first third. Off to a really good start. And you're right, Ray. I can see that holiday type of flavor profile is coming through. I also want to try this with a little bit of eggnog, like nutmeg. Mm. Eggnog. I think that would work too.
Okay.
Sure. A little coquito.
There you go. Sure. Well, even better.
Well. There coquito, you go.
Sure.
Well, there better. Curtis, take your time.
He's coming. He's grabbing me a glass.
I got to break balls. You know, man. I got to break chops.
What's going on, Curtis?
Good evening, gentlemen. I'm well. Yourself?
What's going?
Take a point.
You're pouring a special pairing. What do we have here?
I brought some 100 proof apple brandy.
Apple brandy,
or apple jack if you prefer.
Apple. Sure.
So let's see. After we've dropped the news, we got Jason saying, "Hell yes, 420." There we go.
Yes. For all our friends.
Around, I'm bringing all my money. He will too.
Nah.
Awesome dude.
Maybe we could set up a poker game too after that.
Awesome. So thoughts, Festivus 2022.
It's fantastic. Yeah.
Nice.
Well done. I mean, like I did expected anything different, let's be honest.
Appreciate that.
It's been a minute since I smoked the original blend, so I probably have to refresh my memory on that.
Mm-hmm.
Whether or not this is, it's good, isn't it?
It is good. Yeah. Very good. You guys should try this.
Whether or not it's distinct from the original, I'm getting something, on top of like the expected like espresso and all that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
There's something that I can only describe as like a dark, toasty, almost char, but not like meat char. I don't know how else to frame it, but I'm getting something that reminds me of some of those kind of flavors that come out of something that's been well caramelized or well charred.
What about a charred
maybe?
Or burnt sugar cookie? Again, a little like a really toasted sugar cookie. Again, some ginger snap on that we get.
Yeah,
I could totally see that.
There you go.
Yeah.
But you're not a fan of marshmallows, are you?
Nope.
But awesome. No, yeah, I could see that. I really, after Mallory had mentioned that espresso, and you, Ray, as well, that espresso is really coming through.
Yeah, it's got that espresso bean character to it. 100%.
Box press train. I'm all about it.
Yeah, I hate it, man. I love the box press. I'm a huge fan of the box press sticks, man. They smoke so well. And the smoke output is great.
Okay, so through and they have this word copyrighted. So through this journey, the clowns are
doing shots.
And the society has worked with the clowns on. What would you say is like one of the pinnacle clown moments that you had with what cigar? It's not an easy choice.
It's true.
Definitely not.
Yeah, I mean the one that sticks out in the most is probably the Clown Cero.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And I might like maybe this is like the lazy man's route, but I sometimes default towards the Lanceros that we've had in the society, just because they end up being surprising. Maybe that's me undervaluing Lanceros because of bad experiences with past ones or something. I don't know. But when those come out good, they're really good.
Yes. Yeah. For sure.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Well, and the construction on Clown's Arrow, I mean, it was one of the best constructed lens arrows that I had smoked. The draw, you didn't have to like relight it every 2 seconds. So,
no, that was, yeah. I mean, again, like, listen, at the end of the day, the lens arrow, it's tough. You know, if something they can do, they're too tight. You know, it's a tough that we were really blessed and lucky to have that blend. Had the consistency that it did with that second, even just the flavor all around. That I remember when you tested it for the first time, and we were looking for a Lancero for like 2 years. And we happened to come across the two, which was great. And you took the San Andreas, which I kind of knew you were going to go towards. So I knew that was a no brainer. I said to John, but he's going to take the San Andreas.
Well, it wasn't an easy choice. You didn't make it easy.
I know. I remember the conversation, but. Yeah, no, that was definitely a special. But listen, a lot of the six that I consider all the six we do to be special. They're all unique in their own way, right? They're all different in their own way.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, and again, it kind of pays a testament to our process and how we go about, you know, trying to find, you know, being on the journey and trying to find the best six to put out, and, you know, going through the testing process with, you know, the construction, the blend, the smoke output, and making sure everything's there that kind of hits all of our senses and kind of fits what our clientele likes and enjoys. And I think we've been pretty consistent with that.
Yeah, for sure. And I think that along with the diversity of drops that we can get through the society, the clowns also bring a diversity of their own. Every cigar has a unique profile to it. Do you still have any of the original Festivus?
I do.
Nice. Yeah. Nice. 1 year of age.
Yeah. Mm. They come up to 1 year next month, right? Or January.
Yes, January.
Yeah. So,
but technically, they were in the OGD humidor for a month before that.
Oh, so you're
stuck. You're almost there.
Late November, I believe they were right after Thanksgiving. They were shipped.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Yes.
And we were sitting on them for a while as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But I will say, I think from what I remember, like you, I need to go back and smoke the other one. But I think I am a bit more drawn to the depth and the size of this one a bit more than the other one.
Yeah.
But that could be that AVB was so polarizing that it really like overshadowed the other one.
Yeah, I understand that.
It was
true as well.
Good stuff.
How do you feel about the combination of the spirit and the cigar?
It works really well, and I feel like the just the sheer, like, when you have the sip of the alcohol and then you follow it with this, there's almost like that chocolate turtle
type of
like caramel, like hinted on there somewhere.
I can see that.
Okay.
Yeah, but don't understand. Not
say I agree.
Much a pairing really helps the cigar experience. You know, when you pair any cigar with a different drink, and you can have it with the apple brandy this time. Next time you have it with a hot chocolate or a chocolate martini, it's going to be a totally different smoking experience. And it's really, you got to get the nuances of picking up other flavors, which is probably one of the best things about being a cigar smoker.
Right.
Yeah, I agree. And so I feel like some people get a little caught up in like ruining the purity of the cigar or the drink by combining them.
Yeah.
But you can... You already experienced them each on their own individually. You know what that's like. You know, why not jump in and, you know, get something new every time you combine two things?
I have found that, like, normally Corojo 99 from Aganorsa, but Aganorsa tobacco and a like slightly creamed coffee is like the winning crescendo. It works
all day long.
Yeah.
In the morning or Corojo.
Yeah. We've had this conversation multiple times. I'm a coffee drinker all day long, but I would rather coffee over spirits any day. I take that over spirits first. I mean, I do spirits pairings, but I enjoy my lattes and espressos, and I just feel it brings that unique, it brings that richness out of the cigar.
Right. Yes.
So I would like to know, what does the room smell like with everybody smoking Festivus in there right now? Does it smell like a chocolate factory, a bakery?
No, it's definitely like chocolate, and the Festivus cigar is like synonymous. Like you cannot separate it. It's just it's very enjoyable. And I also feel like with age, and if anyone has the ability and patience to let this sit for a couple years to even kind of smooth a little bit more, it'd be a great morning stick too.
Yeah. I like Joe was saying, even touching on like an espresso martini or even like a Kahlua and milk, you know, mm-hmm. or even like a Bailey's. Right. Like, I think those things kind of resonate into what this blend brings out as far as if you're trying to, you know, really bring out those, that chocolate essence and that like holiday essence out of the stick. That's how I feel about it.
Well, I do have some eggnog that I made that's been aging in my fridge for like a month.
So there you go.
Bring it up. There we go.
There you go.
All right, we're gonna adjourn and we're gonna have this meeting in 1 week when he can bring up the eggnog.
We'll reconvene.
Well, thank you so much for sharing.
Of course.
Ship some and dry ice to us so we have it.
Salud. Gentlemen, thank you. Wonderful as always.
Appreciate it, man.
So we got a question from you, from Chris Hamilton, saying, how can we get some of the Cigar Clowns gear? Where would
CigarClowns.com.
Nice and easy.
Simple. CigarClowns.com. Hoodies, hats, lighters, cutters, ashtrays, cigar stands, whatever you want.
Man, that sweetness is really ramping up.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. In the middle.
Oh, yeah.
Yo, you're still in the beginning. I'm in the middle already.
Yeah, I'm slow burning it. Chip, so let's see here. Rob Brown saying, I have only smoked one ABV, but still have two in my humidor. Hopefully, Rob, we can get you a few more. There's not a lot to go around, but we will have some for the event.
I might steal some.
Yeah, hello? I might need some, hello? Too. I brought my last bit to Provodicon.
Yeah, that's true.
What's going on, bud?
This is Chip.
What's up, Chip?
For running on.
Hey, guys.
What's up?
Echoing the thoughts of everybody else, I will tell the clowns one thing. If you guys didn't know this about Eric, he has an OCD thing about the cigar, about his burn line, and he hasn't touched it up yet.
It's true. Not a single touch-up. Not a single touch-up.
Neither have I. I know you can't see it, but
neither have I, man. I always expect the best flavor from you guys, but the construction of this is amazing. The box press. I like box press because they don't roll off the golf cart. That's the main thing.
That's a good analogy.
But just before I lit it up, just a great looking cigar. I mean, just aesthetically
beautiful
cigar. And like, I haven't touched it at all. I haven't tried to keep the ash on it, but it's just like perfect. So
stacking dimes. We gotta patent that too, Joe. Stacking dimes.
Stacking dimes, babe. So I get the sweetness everybody's talking about. I've been smoking cigars for a few years, and I'm still not the guy who can tell you, oh yeah, that's like damp hay or something else. I'm not that guy. I just know when I like it. So I'm susceptible to suggestions sometimes, but the espresso, the chocolatey, the kind of edgy, a bitter kind of, you know, so home run, love it. So it's, you know, for me, it's hard to compete with the Clown Cerro, but
okay. So is that your tops?
Well, I think the Clown Cerro, just the story that, you know, it was kind of like our cigar or your cigar.
The first OGT exclusive.
Yeah. So that was kind of the thing.
That's awesome.
And I've never been a big Lancero guy, but like, you know, one thing is with Lancero, is you always have to relight them, and it's a chore to kind of take care of them. But that just burned perfectly. That's got me to where now I'm trying more Lanceros, and I like Lonsdale's.
Yes, Lonsdale.
Okay.
What I'm finding interesting about this, in like I'm coming just approaching the second third. The richness of flavor is reminiscent to what you have in a last third of a cigar. Like that sweet spot that you normally like, oh, okay, now it's transitioning. I can feel it. It's normally towards the end. You're like, this is a very quick timeline. The timer's ticking down because there's not much. We're down to the last third, but the depth has already started reaching in there. Really impressive. Really impressive. Just getting better.
So, I mean, the Clown Cerro was like what we were talking about earlier. It's definitely a special stick, and it was the first OGT exclusive, and it certainly won't be the last.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And that's great news for us.
It will not be the last, I promise you that.
I remember smoking that stick on this call, and I was with Boston Jimmy in a cigar shop in Florida.
Yes.
Boston Jimmy from Stogie Press. And he put the Lancero down. He went into the bar, got a drink, came back, used the restroom, and took a puff and goes, that passed the test. Because it was still lit. You know, and he's like, I was like, man, that was pretty impressive right there.
Yes, yes. So I got to catch up on some of these comments here. Let's see here. We got Raider Dave saying, wow, for me, this cigar tastes like a whiskey barrel aged coffee with a splash of caramel and cream and a little cinnamon sprinkled on top. Outstanding. There you go.
Thank
bada
you.
Bing, bada boom.
Too bad he could be more specific.
Yeah.
First, that's not the select. I don't know what that's like.
He's hammered.
And Jason's saying Ray's given him an idea for breakfast. Rob Brown is going to hold me to getting him an AVB. We'll make sure we get something happening. Let's see here. Zach Andrews, the sweetness is very earthy as well. Definitely. So a lot of things going on. Yeah. A lot of things going on.
And I'd also like to say, you know, the fact that you guys are going to come out here is amazing for us because, you know, we've been around Eric, and Eric's the best guy we know. He's such a great guy. I think he does a lot of things the way
I bribed him with a few cigars.
Yeah. But, you know, he does things the right way. So having you guys come out in April, we're super psyched about it.
It's going to be awesome. Yeah.
Yeah, man. So, we're looking forward to it. It's been in talks for a long time, and you know, getting to spend a lot of quality time with Eric at Provodicon was definitely what I thought it would be, and hanging out with him and his brother, and you know, just you know, smoking and talking shop, and just hanging out and shooting the shit. It's like I feel like I know Eric for 20 years.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, before he went, I'd like to see these guys, but I'm going to meet the clowns.
Well, and here's the thing I will say too is, I mean, we've had some great, great manufacturers come to our shop, done events, really, really cool. And I mean, we've gotten sold out nights and it's been awesome, but I don't know if there's been this much buzz around an little event we've done as much as the potential of the Cigar Clown crew rolling out to California. Yeah. So we're really looking forward to it. It's going to be awesome.
What was the other one that you didn't get? You got the Clown Cerro, the other one that I like.
Oh, he also, he threw in a vote for a Scaramouche. He really liked
that. Nice. Oh, Scaramouche. Great stick.
I still have four of them in my humidor. I'm afraid to smoke them.
Yeah, man. That was you want to talk about special stick. That was a special stick, man.
You know, as good as a Clown Cerro was, that Scaramouche. I'm like, oh my god. I started looking online for them. Oh my god, they were so good.
Now you almost got January will be another year age on it.
Yeah. So they're sitting there.
I'm gonna throw a shameless plug in for the Cigar Clowns Roadies. They're doing a Toys for Tots drive. If you Instagram Frank Ranger Proud, or you can Instagram me. For $15, you can get in on a whole bunch of rare sticks. There's multiple drawings. I don't know if there's 35 packs right now. And then if you buy $100 worth of raffle tickets, you can get all the sticks you can't find no more. The Crinkles, the OG 2018 stick, you know, the OG Ron, the all different test blends. So I would suggest anybody watching that wants a chance of winning the Scaramouche, the Clown Cerro, the Flaco, the Paisa. If you want a chance of winning these sticks for $15, it's well worth it. And
there you go.
I think they got many toys. They raised over $3,000 so far.
And it's awesome.
The Roadies, they're doing awesome, man.
That's great. Yeah.
Can we get a link for that?
Just hit him up on Cigar Clowns Joe on Instagram.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, man. Sorry to throw a plug out there, but for the kids.
No.
Gotta do it for the kids.
If I get more Scaramouche for $100, I'm good.
Yeah.
Hey, there's an idea from Chris for the event. He's saying you may need to get a big top. There you go. Make it a circus event. There you go.
might need to get a big top, a dunk tank. You know, if we're going to raise money for charity. I don't know the weather out there in April, so I don't want to raise my hand and say I'll do it. But
yeah. Exactly. Break the ice in the tank first.
We'll get Eric in there. That'll be fine.
I don't know.
But no,
Eric in a speedo.
Yeah. Eric in a speedo? Oh, good Lord.
No one will take
it. You can get one of those old-timey striped bathing
suits.
There
you go. 1920s bathing suit.
There you go.
1920s bathing suit. There you go. With the cap. With swim cap. Yeah.
Get some slippers on him.
I'm in.
Great, man.
I'm in. I'll pay to see that.
It's all made out of wool. You go in the water, you drown in that fucking thing. Man.
Yeah.
But again, thanks so much for your support of Eric. That's a blessing for all of us. And we just can't say enough good things about him and about you guys because we love all your sticks. Like I said, I never worry about the quality of the sticks. They're always top notch. So it's like, okay, Cigar Clowns. Okay, I got it.
Yeah, it's the reverse. When you guys say it's the night before the stress level, I'm like, well, when it's the OGT drop, I'm on vacation. It's fine. We'll be all right.
We don't even care. Like, Cigar Clowns? Okay, we'll smoke it.
Yeah.
You can't, you know.
Well, we appreciate the love, man. And it's very nerve wracking, especially, you know, for us. Cause,
the experience of how popular cigars are now and everybody else thinks they can, it's easy to make cigars. Let's do it. You know?
Yeah. Right. Right.
Yeah.
So it's good to see you guys are successful. And it's easy to support good guys. So it's fine. Yeah, we're good.
Appreciate that.
I appreciate that, Jim. Thank
you. All right, man. God bless. Thanks a lot.
Awesome. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
That's an idea for you too. Is when you get your like magnum opus cigar and you're like, this is it. This is one of it. You should name it the night before. And then just that on that particular night, just take a rest and be like, no, we've got it.
Yeah.
That's it. That's it. I'm a very nervous guy when it comes to that.
Well, you're also the numbers guy, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Numbers. I'm the janitor. I do whatever it takes. That's it.
He's the janitor, and I got to be the consigliere. I got to be like, listen, Joe. It'll be all right, Joe. It's all right. Yeah, good. Good. Don't worry about it.
I'm always on the warpath, too.
Forget about it.
Yeah. That's Forget it. About it.
So this is Nick. Nick, thanks for jumping on.
What's up, Nick?
You're actually further in than I am. What are your thoughts?
I'm enjoying it a lot. But again, like everyone's saying, can't get enough of you guys' sticks. I mean,
appreciate it, bro.
Can't ever go wrong so far. Well, can't quite say that. The 5150 keeps kicking me in the teeth.
Yeah, 5150 was a bit strong for him.
Yeah, man.
It's a big cigar, man. It's a big cigar.
Yeah.
But I was realizing, I can't remember who I was talking to, but this year as well as like kind of experiencing new experiences with cigars, this year has been a good year for 6x60s. I mean, like your guys' 5150, Last Rites, Castaño from Stallone, like really good blends translating to that size, which is impressive.
And it's funny you say that because I was actually having this conversation with Joe right around the time when we dropped 5150, when we retested it and we were going to drop it. After we dropped it and smoking it a couple of times and doing lives and stuff like that, I kind of find myself going to the local shops and humidors and picking up 58, 60 ring gauges and smoking them like, wow, like I used to always smoke. The funny story that Nick tells about me all the time, when I first started my cigar journey 20 plus years ago, I would always smoke big range ring gauges. I wouldn't smoke 38, 42, 50, okay. 52. I like only 60 ring gauges and above. That's what I smoked. That's what I enjoyed. So like revisiting that aspect of my journey and kind of going back into that for a short period of time and experiencing that, it kind of brought me back a little bit of nostalgia of like, you know, enjoying those bigger size ring gauges. I don't normally smoke the bigger ring gauges, but kind of brought me back down that path for a little bit. So I kind of find myself, oh, they got this the new stick out. Oh, they got it in a 6x60 or a 7x55.
Right.
Or
I kind of,
you know, got back into that diversity of going, you know, back and forth in sizes.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. I mean, 6x60 Olmec Maduro.
Yeah,
there you go.
That is one of my favorite sticks this year.
Yeah, it's a good one. It's a good one.
It's a great stick, and I was blown away by the Maduro, man. Honestly.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
The other one I got to smoke again. What's the other one they made also?
The natural, the Claro.
The Claro. I got to smoke that again. I got to smoke. I got to revisit that one. But the Maduro blew me away.
And by the way, talking about new sticks for this year that I'm enjoying, I just the Blackened by Drew Estate.
Oh, pretty good.
Unbelievable. 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 That has every characteristic of a blend that fits my palate. It's a San Andreas wrapper with a Connecticut broadleaf binder. It's got Nicaraguan Vijero with a Pennsylvania broadleaf filler. It is ridiculous, and it burns so slow.
Well,
flavor bomb.
Nice.
It's
nice.
A killer stick.
Right, right.
There you
We're
go.
We're over here now. We're over here now.
No. I gotta show love to my Thursday and Jonathan Jerome.
Nice. So we got a question here, and I'm gonna pose it to you first. Nick is saying, Eric, what is the best Cigar Clown stick of the year in your opinion? Before I answer that, I actually want to hand that over to Nick. What was your top pick?
I'm trying to think of all the ones because I mean they've all been killer. I'm trying to go over them all in my head that we've had. I actually would have to say, like Chip said, and some of the others, the Clown Cerro.
Clown Cerro's a win here.
I'm not normally one for Lanceros, so that's why it's kind of surprising. It doesn't burn or smoke like a Lancero. It smokes like a normal cigar. You don't have to fight it. It's just a fun burn throughout the entire burn of the stick.
Mm-hmm.
And the flavor profile doesn't hit you super hard, but it's a nice lounge cigar to smoke with. I think I did it actually recently with coffee for one of my morning smokes, and it was a really good morning stick.
Nice.
So yeah, I would definitely say the Clown Cerro would definitely be up there on the top. Close second, even though it keeps kicking me in the teeth, would be the 5150 because it's so memorable.
Yeah.
So
and it's kind of, I feel like Festivus doesn't get a fair shake in this answer because this is the first one I've smoked. So I got to smoke more of them. I can definitely say this is leaving more of an impression than last year's, like even more. Last year, it was kind of the highlight of the society when that Festivus came around. Everyone was like, oh, that stick hands down. For me personally, I think that it's a little biased to say Clown Cerro because it was our first exclusive, but I would say it probably is 5150.
Really?
I think they're at that bar really high, but 5150, I think, dethroned it. It's just, it's got so much what I love about Nicaraguan tobacco. It's really good.
And I know you said that you were kind of torn between the both of them for a little bit. You're like, I don't know, it's 5150, Heartbreak. I'm like,
I love the Heartbreak.
5150.
Well, to be honest, 5150 would be actually at my top if it wasn't constantly just beating me.
Yeah.
Like, I smoke and I'm like, this is great. And then a few minutes later, I'm just like, oh God, that's a little much.
So I want to pose that same question to everyone watching. Drop down in the comments. Throw your vote because we're about to hit that like season where everyone and their mom has got a cigar list. Best cigar of the year, best cigar of the year. Drop down, best cigar clown of the year. And I'll go ahead and pull it up. We've got James here saying Heartbreaker for the win.
He's
vote for that.
I like that. I like that, James.
I've only tried the Heartbreaker, 51, and Festivus. So out of the three, he's got that. We got Raider Dave saying Clown Cerro is an awesome stick. But for me, it's a close tie between Heartbreaker, Flacco, and 5150. There you go.
Great sticks right there.
Like 5150, actually.
Not a lot of Scaramouche votes out there, huh?
Got got Nick saying Festivus 2022 for him. Like I said, I need to smoke a few more. I probably should have been smoking more before this, but it's no, fantastic. It's, well done.
It's great that it's the first time you're smoking it, man. It really
actually,
is.
Actually,
I'm honored to smoke it for the first time again.
And I don't know if this counts, but I would also say one of my top picks has got to be that Clown Labs Sumatra. That's cigar.
So from, that's a special cigar, that Sumatra.
Really
but
good.
That's just a taste of what's coming out of the Clowns Labs for 2023. We are getting funky. We are getting crazy. Yeah, we are taking the journey to the next level. All different tobaccos. We got different sources of tobaccos. We are going. It's going to be fun. 2023, buckle up. Cigar
funky
Clowns.
Town is going to be our fucking song this year.
Yeah, we're taking you guys on the ride next year. The journey continues, man. We're gonna find that perfect stick. I don't know if it's gonna be next year, the year after that, 20 years from now. I don't know. But we
you ever go into the fun house with the mirrors, the different types of mirrors?
That's it.
There we go.
We're gonna have a lot of fun. We just smoked a cigar the other day for the Clowns Labs, one of our blends that we're working, and it burnt Ray's face off. Where Ray was leaking out of his nose, his eyes, his ears, sneezing. It was just the heat on the. It came about in what the final third.
Yeah.
It was It was like somebody gave you a ghost pepper, mm-hmm. and it just engulfed your face. I mean, we got to tone it down a little bit. You know? But man, so I didn't know you can get something like that in tobacco.
So for those who don't know, this is a little bit of a subsidiary from the Clowns. Clown Labs is something that we've been working on for a while that we're rolling out, with the Sumatra being the first with our testing, you know, and it's coming. It's going to go full blown in 2023 with, you know, exclusives and stuff like that. It's going to be something that we're going to front line for 2023. So stay tuned for that. That's definitely something that you're going to see. You're going to see that logo in a lot of places.
Definitely.
Awesome. Awesome. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, man.
Thank you so much, Nick, for jumping on.
Thank you for having me. Take care, guys. And looking
Nick,
forward
nice to meet you, man. Nice looking forward to meeting with you, man.
Yes. Well, no. And 2023 is going to be awesome. I'm looking forward to it. We've got a lot of people answering that the vote, and it looks like overall we've got a few. We got Ben saying Scaramouche.
There you go.
Saying that Sumatra is amazing. Mm. Another one for Scaramouche. But overall, it seems like Heartbreaker is taking the lead.
Well, I mean, let's go to your video skills on the Heartbreaker. I mean,
I brought that up earlier.
Yeah, it's just crazy, man.
We appreciate it.
We got Nick posing a question for you guys, saying, Joe, give them some examples of types of tobacco that is being used. I know you've kind of told us a little bit of experience. Is there any, like, wrapper leaf tobacco or anything you might be able to drop?
I will just say that, do you know there's tobacco being grown in Ireland?
No.
There you go. There you go. We are getting funky, man. We're getting funky. I'm telling you right now.
Nice.
Changing the game.
There we go.
We've been
looking forward to it.
Yeah, man. It's been a ride, and we're almost there.
But that's of course, that's like the best part, is the journey itself. You almost wish you don't reach that ultimate stick, because it becomes the ultimate stick.
That's right. But there's so many palates in the cigar smoking world. We'll never, you know, we'll get there one day.
Yes.
But, you know,
so this is Mike. Mike, thanks for jumping on. First of all,
Mike,
was Heartbreak.
Nice to meet you.
I'm not sure. I mean, I love them.
Okay.
I've got them. I got all the bands all over my computer.
That's great.
On Festivus 2022.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really like it a lot. It hits my palate perfectly. Yeah, I get some cocoa and leather. I mean, I don't have a sophisticated palate, even though I've been smoking these things for over 40 years. But this is, I mean, their cigars are always good. This is a great cigar.
Nice. Really good.
Well, you happen, your home shop happens to be OGT's, and in my opinion, he is one of the best tobacconists in the country, man. So he's really elevating the game when it comes to, you know, enhancing everybody's palates with all the cigars he's getting in his society, and that I can tell you.
And we've had the honor of being featured five times in society, and we greatly appreciate the respect and the bump that we get from you guys.
You guys hold the record. I don't see you guys getting dethroned at any time soon. So
appreciate that.
Yeah, let us know if somebody's getting close. We'll have to clip them.
Yeah.
And I really like the 5150.
Okay, and 5150. Really like, some people say it's really strong
for them. And
yeah,
and I'm a medium guy.
Yeah, yeah.
And I found it just to be really full of flavor and
kind
of medium plus. And mm-hmm. I mean, and I say I always save one cigar from the society.
Nice.
And my humidor is getting pretty full now. Actually, I had to start a second humidor because I've got so many ones I've saved. But I was looking in there today at that 5150, and I was like, man, that's looking really good right now. I got one of everything, you know.
That's going to be hard to hold on to for another year, because that you have to break out next Halloween.
It is. Well, and are you a 6x60 smoker?
Yes.
Okay, so that's more than your
That's my favorite size right there.
Definitely. Well, and that is, again, I mean, we talk about this with the society. We talk about the clown. You have things like as high as the 6x60, then you got a clown Cerro box press 40 gauge, it opens the door to try so many new things. And myself, I'm not always one to go for a 6x60, but when it's a blend that good, it's that good. It's worth trying.
I'm a petite Corona type of smoker because I never have enough time. So, you know, that's my go-to. But, you know, part of the journey is we try all the different Vitolas and, you know, and that's what makes the cigar experience so great. And if I'm with a guy, that's Nick next to you. I'm sorry. Eric, who's next to you right now? Mike, I'm sorry about that. Mike, if I'm with you and you gave me a, you know, a 6x60, I would smoke it and I would just, you know, listen to you to take the notes on it and, you know, what I'm smoking. And if you were smoking a Petite Corona, I would tell you this is what I'm experiencing. And that's what makes the cigar world so great.
You know, and that's, again, kind of going to what Joe's saying, you know, that's kind of the question that we get a lot from people. You know, it's like you guys got five, you know, five partners in the brand, you know, when you go through your testing process, like you have so many cooks in the kitchen, like how do you guys come up with a decision to put out a blend? That's the diversity that we have in the experience, because you got myself, Nick, and Joe, who are on the upper echelons of cigar smoking experience. And when you got Murph and Danny, which are kind of in the middle and the lower cusp, and they've kind of learned from us, we've kind of learned from them in generating palates and kind of figuring things out. And like Joe, you know, Joe described, he's not really a big ring gauge cigar guy. So like me, I kind of like the big range cigar, so I can give him more of a feedback of what I'm getting him. Like, oh, all right, I get that. Okay, I see what you're saying with that. And I can go to the same thing for him on a small ring gauge stick because I'm getting X, Y, and Z. So we kind of bounce off of one another. Now, at the end of the day, there's five cooks in the kitchen. But the good part about it is that, you know, listen, every cigar that we've ever put out, there's a couple that I didn't absolutely love, but everybody else did. But you know what? We have to think in our minds. Is the customer gonna like it? Is the customer gonna be like, oh, this is a really good thing? Because it's not my particular palate. Joe knows my palate just as well as I know Joe's palate. And I know what Joe likes, and I know he knows what I like. There are certain cigars that fit my palate clientele. There are certain palates that there's certain cigars that fit his clientele. I kind of try to understand where he's coming from and pick up on those things. So it's every testing that we go through is a learning experience, and we're continuing to learn and grow as a brand and testing and smoking it. I think it just makes us, you know, better each one that we do.
And also, rock, paper, scissors plays an important role in tiebreakers. Just want to let everybody know that. That's it. Come on, rock.
Has there ever been, like, a tumultuous, like, voting system? Like, a particular cigar that, like, was split down the middle? Like, you guys liked, didn't like?
I could tell you one that I strong-armed was the Crinkles. I didn't give them a chance. They had to smoke it, and they, we were going with it. That was super special cigar.
Go ahead, Ray.
No. So like even with the Sumatra, I'm not a huge. I don't love Sumatras, right? I've kind of found myself liking them a little bit more. And Joe's like, dude, you have to fucking smoke the stick. You have it's so good. And the first time we tested it, I'm like, I don't know, man. Like, I'm on the fence. I'm like, he goes, dude, with a little bit of age, this cigar is going to be great. I'm like, all right. But just for me, like, it's not like a yes. It's I'm in because, you know, you're a Sumatra guy. You know your Sumatras. I will trust you. You know, like, I would trust Joe. Joe would take a bullet for me. I would do the same for him. But now that it's sat longer and I smoked it again, what, three nights ago? And I was blown away. I was like, Joe, dude, this cigar aged unbelievable. And it's 10 times what it was when we first tested it. So again, that kind of pays testament to our process. I wasn't really feeling it in the beginning, the first couple of times I smoked it, but smoking it now, it's like, wow, like, holy shit, it aged so well.
Yeah. So funny story with the Sumatra is that at the end, Ray's like, I'm getting a little tin on the end of it. It was a wet cigar, you know, it was wet when we first smoked it. I was like, tin. You're supposed to be getting aluminum, not tin. You know,
aluminum foil, aluminum foil, aluminum foil, aluminum foil.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Mike, for joining on.
Keep up the good work, guys. Man.
Thanks, Mike.
So we'll see you soon. We got Nick saying, Eric, what's the most popular size at OGT? I would probably say, hands down, probably Toro. Toro is probably the biggest, the most common.
My favorite size.
Not as much Robusto as you would expect, but I think I attribute that to is the fact that we're in California tax, dealing with a shorter cigar. there's always that type of like value perception in there as well.
Right. Yeah. Right.
Which is unfortunate because some cigars I feel like smoke better in their Robusto format than they do in the Toro. So
yeah, just, that's true.
Yeah,
I agree with that.
That's right. And even like with the box press, like you were saying earlier, like box press for me, it's always generally, I mean, you get some that aren't, but generally speaking, the box press just smokes so well. And I feel like you get so much more of a better smoking experience in a box press than other Vitolas. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
I like just the mouth feel on a box press.
Yeah, and the mouth feel too. Yeah, I agree with that.
So last, you want to jump on? So we got Matt jumping on. He's going to be our last society member. There's quite a bit of society people here. Unless Zeke wants to jump on.
Jump on.
Eric, you got to have Zeke on. New Yorker, New York fan.
Jeez, I know, right?
Matt, thank you for joining.
Hi, right, gentlemen.
What's up, Matt?
What are you pairing tonight?
So I'm having some of the famous Curtis Apple brandy.
Mm. Apple seems to be the go-to, huh?
We are in Oakland. This is an Apple town.
Okay. Nice. Okay. I respect that.
So, thoughts on Festivus 2022?
So, well, this is different together. This is my first drink of that.
This is different. So, chocolate turtle. Caramel chocolate turtle.
So my thoughts are I like how mild it is to me. It was having a good round note. It's a good fall season cigar.
Yeah. It's got that occasional.
Yeah. And that's what's hitting me right now, because I was talking to the guys over here and I'm like, I know you guys are gonna look at me weird when I say this, but I feel like I taste notes of like a wet aspen leaf, like when you're out in the fields.
Okay.
Like in Mammoth or even Colorado, of course.
Yeah.
And that's what it just has, that nice fall feel, relaxing, easy smoke. I'm really enjoying the leather, the cocoa. I know it's probably not in there, but it just has like a slight hint of what feels like a Virginia leaf in there. Just like a subtle feel, like a Virginia leaf. It's just interesting. And I picked that note. It's still in the retro.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. But here's the funny thing. You say you don't know if we don't particularly taste it, but again, it's your journey into the stick. So you're going to get notes that other people might not get. You might pick up on nuances that others don't get. So if that's something that you're picking up, that you're feeling that's on your palate, that just paints a testament to where your palate is and how refined your palate is and some certain things that you taste that others might not.
Next correction. Not Virginia leaf, Turkish leaf.
You get a very nice retro. You get a little pepper on that retro that just really enhances you know, your whole experience on this stick particularly.
And I'm at it's a beautiful cigar, gentlemen. Good job.
Thank you, man.
Blending.
Thank
appreciate it.
So what would you say your clown pick for this year that you've tried?
Tough one. I think all the cigars that I've had from Clown has been all my favorites in society this year. Every single one has just been my favorite.
I think the only one that, like, I'm not gonna say only one, because each, the thing about when we do the society, it's also trying to hit those like diverse palates and try something new, stuff like that. One that really, really captured me on a like clown level was that Chaffee Osino Eagle. That Lonsdale box press.
That's right.
And I've got to send you guys some of those. Those are incredible.
Those are good too.
Dude, you have those my credit card information on file. Charge me. I like what that guy's doing, man. He's raising a lot of money for a good cause too.
Yes.
Great guy.
This is a good guy. We got to meet him at Provodicon. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Great guy.
Nice.
Thank you for the introduction, by the way. It was
of course. And he's working on one of our projects that we're working on towards 2023 is a Brazilian Modafina by him. Good stuff.
Nice.
Good stuff.
Very nice. I love it.
So where are you at in the cigar, Eric? What are you thinking? Talk to me.
About this one?
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like I don't know if I would say strength, but the flavor, it heads uphill. Like it just ramps up all the way through. Definitely more earthy coming towards it. Still that like hot chocolate, Mexican hot chocolate. The pepper and spice is really mellowed out some. And more like, I don't know, almost like a pumpkin sweetness, like a pumpkin spice sweetness to it.
Now you're blowing smoke.
But it's getting more meatier.
It's clowning around over here.
I can imagine how cloudy it is in there right now with the dragon clouds.
It's actually more cloudy outside. It's strangely very clear in here. All the fog rolling should look like it's cloudy, but it's actually nice in here right now. You'd be very comfortable.
I think we're going to need to start marketing cigar clown cigar eater companies and say, you don't need a fog machine. Just pick up 5 sticks, get extras to smoke it, and you'll be good.
There you go. Yeah.
That's it.
Like I told you, I know you're not there yet, and we're going to get off before then, but that final third, man.
Yeah, I'm just now on the cut.
I'm in mine right now, the final third. It is right there. A little more spice. It's beautiful, relaxing, warm, but still on that, for me, like more on the mild, just earthy, round, excitingly relaxing at the same time. It's just a perfect fall cigar.
Really good bringing in for Black Friday, too. Opportune time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Matt.
You're welcome, gentlemen.
Matt, nice to meet you, man. Thank you.
You bet.
Awesome. Well, we're coming to the hour mark, but I mean, well done. I definitely need to. I think every cigar needs to be smoked a few times to get like the best rounded opinion on it.
Great.
But definitely up there. I mean, this did not disappoint at all. And to me, from first impression, I'm enjoying it even better than last year's for certain.
Appreciate it,
man.
I agree.
Appreciate it. We're gonna have a fun 2023. You know. And we're going to keep on moving forward. Happy Festivus. The errands, agreements. You know, honestly, don't have to cut down any trees. You get your metal pole. Rest a little bit. You know?
Definitely. Definitely. And it's always great hanging out with you guys. We got some, for people watching, really cool stuff planned for this coming year. And if you have the opportunity to stop by OGT, meet the clowns, come to the shop, it's going to be an awesome time. You're not going to want to miss it.
If everybody did not smoke that Sumatra stick and they want to smoke it with us next Tuesday, we can do something on our Zoom meeting for your society. So
I'm down.
We'll put it out there now. We'll be available.
Yeah. Now is that a Zoom meeting that you guys want to host and then we'll jump in on with you guys?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
This way get everybody on there. You know, you can have it at your lounge. You know. We'd love to smoke that with a bunch of people.
Well, sorry, it's so fun. Earlier. When we were out there in Florida talking to you guys, and I hadn't even smoked the Sumatra yet. And we got the 200 that were unbanded, and the original plan was send back those, get a different 200 that were banded. In the back of my mind, I was like, you know what? I'm just going to hold on to these. I'm just going to hold on to them. And I am so glad I did, because now we've got even – on top of some other stuff, we've got some exclusive event sticks, and that Sumatra is just, it's a banger. It's so good.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So if you want to put it out there where you got everybody in the society there, we'll definitely set something up. We'll talk over the weekend, and we'll definitely make something work on Tuesday.
Definitely. Definitely. And that's the thing, too, is I keep telling people, even though there's only one, make certain that you smoke it. It's always good to hang on to it and stuff, but since there's only one, you need to experience it. Don't just bury it in your humidor. It needs to be smoked.
That's a cigar that needs to be smoked. It's part of the journey. I get it, man. I'm a collector myself. A lot of rare stuff I want to hold on to, but that's a cigar needs to be experienced. That's it. You know.
So, similarly, for me personally, which was the release like way back in the day that is like that Churchill box press size?
That's the Crinkles.
That's the Crinkles.
So you guys gave me one of those. I haven't lit it up yet. I'm gonna have to smoke it and let you guys know.
You gotta smoke that, man. Let me know. I'll smoke. I have limited amount of them. I'll smoke it with you. That's
we could jump on a live and smoke it live if you want. I don't have any. I have one left. I'm not smoking it. I'll smoke something else.
That's a special stick. I actually traded for two Crinkles recently.
Oh, really?
somebody was on the Discord. Like, I'm looking for the 5150s. I got Crinkles. I was like, oh, sold. Let's go.
Nice. Yeah. Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much for joining us tonight. It's always great to hang out. We'll try to jump on with you guys Tuesday, smoke that Sumatra.
Yeah, that's all for works.
Onward and upward. Looking forward to the next year. And what a way to close out this year's society. Like, again, one of the most exciting drops of the year.
We're blessed to have you, man. Thank you. Thank you for featuring us in the society. And 2 months in a row, man. That's like
2 months in a row.
Back to back.
There we go. Awesome. Well, you guys have a great night. Thank you again.
You too, Eric.
Peace.